Hello everyone, exercise is question number 28. It is basically a question of time and distance, where a train covered a certain distance at a uniform speed. If the train had been 13 km per hour faster, it would have taken 2 hours less than the scheduled time. If the train was slower by 15 km per hour, it would have taken 2 hours more than the scheduled time. Find the length of the journey. Suppose we take that the speed of the train is x km per hour. And the time it takes is y hours. It means the total scheduled distance is x multiplied by y. Because the formula of distance is speed multiplied by time. When the speed we assume is x km per hour and time we have assumed is y hours, it means the total distance it is covering is x multiplied by y. If the train had been 30 km per hour slower, faster, then the speed becomes x plus 30. And it would have taken 2 hours less. Definitely when the speed increases, the time it takes will be less. So the time will be y minus 2, and this should be equal to xy, that is the total distance it covers. The second can be, it is slower by 15 km per hour, that is x minus 15. And the time increases by 2 hours, that is x plus 2, it is also equal to x into y. So these are basically the two equations we can formulate in our simultaneous equation, and then we have to solve it. If we look at the first equation, it is xy plus 30y minus 2x minus 60 is equals to xy. This xy can be cancelled by this xy. If we take this on the right hand side, the equation becomes minus 2x plus 30y is equals to 60. So this is the first equation we can talk about. If we look at the second equation, it is xy minus 15y plus 2x minus 30 is equals to xy. Again, these can be cancelled out, and the final equation becomes 2x minus 15y is equals to 30. When we take this 30 on the right hand side, it becomes plus 30, and this is the second equation. Now we directly add them. I already told you, if the sign of these two are different, then it is always better to add them. If the sign is same and coefficients are same, then we have to subtract so that they can cancel out. So if we are adding them, this will cancel out. This becomes 15y and this becomes 90. So the value of y becomes 6. And already we know that it is in the time which is defined. So it is 6 hours. So the total time it takes is 6 hours. If we look at any of the equation, either we put it in this equation or this equation, we can find out the value of y. Minus 2x plus 30y is equals to 60. This is given. The value of y is 6. So minus 2x plus 30 into 6 is 180 is equals to 60. We can say minus 2x becomes minus 120. That is 60 minus 180. If we look at x comes out to be minus 120 upon minus 2, calculating it becomes 60, and this is in kilometer per hour because it is the speed which we have defined. So the speed is 60 km per hour and the time it takes is 6 hours. Now the question is the length of journey, that is the distance of the journey, which is x multiplied by y. So 60 km per hour at a speed of 6, and this is 360 kilometers. So this is the total length of the journey. If in case you have any problem regarding this, you can contact or email us. And next class we will talk about question number 29 onwards. Thank you.